now set to make his way to the ring, Luis Collazo.
Former titleist who is hungry for much more. Luis Collazo has said that he feels Thurman is overlooking him. He says, I've fought the bigger names than he has. Thurman hasn't climbed the ladder of success that I have. Tonight, a little extra motivation. His mother, Margarita, who's been dealing with health issues, she made the trip to be here. There she is in the white shirt. First time that his mother, Margarita, has been ringside to see her son fight. Brooklyn born and raised and proud of his Puerto Rican heritage. The former titleist with one more big opportunity, now just moments away.
Now making his way to the ring, Keith, one time.
Great reception in front of the home fans. A sold out Sun Dome here at USF. The moment Thurman's waited for 5.5 years to ring walk in front of these fans in Tampa. But this time he does so as a star on the precipice of even greater stardom. He grew up in nearby Clearwater. He was just 7 years old when he was a schoolboy and a school janitor running a youth boxing program. Took him under his wing, taught him the craft. Modest, but hungry, and that's refreshing considering that he's already a titleist. He's making good money with riches ahead, and now twice has been the headliner for a primetime national TV debut of the PBC on a network. Keith Thurman has arrived, and he is tagged as the next great one we will see here against Collazo. For the official introductions, here is Sweet Baby Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the USF Sun Dome here in Tampa, Florida, Premier Boxing Champions now presents the main events of the evening. Live on ESPN, 12 rounds for the Welterweight Championship. The three judges ringside are Alex Levin, William Ray, and Michael Ross. And the referee in charge, when the bell sounds, Telus Asimenios. Introducing first out of the red corner, wearing red with gold trim. He is a 42-5 fight veteran who holds a record of 36 wins, opposite 6 defeats, 19 wins coming by way of knockouts. From Brooklyn, New York, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Luis Collazo. So, across the ring, his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing red, whites, and blue. He enters the ring undefeated, 25 bouts, 25 victories, 21 of those come in by way of knockouts. Fighting out of Clearwater, Florida, ladies and gentlemen, presenting Keith Wartime.
Now, earlier tonight, Teddy Atlas offered up his signature fight plan. Teddy, give us a reminder of what each fighter should be targeting here.
Well, for Thurman, you're fighting a southpaw. Usually the southpaw killer is the right hand. They get hit with it. How do you set it up? Well, you feint. Collazo, get him. Notice that 95% of the time, he moves his head to his left. So feint him or jab. Get him over on that side right in front of your right hand and land the right hand, and maybe you go home. Make all these people happy. Collazo, but when Thurman throws his right hand, we know he's gonna throw, we just said it. He does one thing more, he drops his left hand. So get away from the right hand, and then counter with the right hook. Get ready to collect $1 million. You just hit the jackpot, baby. You know, I'm talking about the right hand of Thurman, but the best weapon for a southpaw, the right hook. Why? Because orthodox fighters like Thurman not used to seeing it come from that angle. Their peripheral vision doesn't always pick it up.
Here we go. Collazo and Thurman.
I tell you, for a loud night so far, we've had a lot of quiet bells. Thurman likes to hurt guys early. I guess anybody would like to hurt somebody early if you're a fighter. But the reason he plans on it, because his trainer told him, Ben Getty, we talked a lot about him already, we showed a lot of features about him, told him that when they feel your power, it changes their attitude. In other words, it intimidates guys. And when you can intimidate somebody, your night becomes a little easier.
He has dropped his last five opponents to the canvas.
And let me tell you,
knockdowns in sensational style too, Teddy.
You see the way he thinks? The way his trainer Ben Getty thought? Mike Tyson and his people thought the same way. He would come out there, try to land something to make you say, yeah, the things you heard about me, they're true. And then again, you become passive and the job becomes easier. Matter of fact, Tyson took it to another level. You know, sometimes he would stare at you to intimidate you. Sometimes instead of a punch, he might even hit you an elbow. But the bottom line, you intimidate someone, the theory is you make the fight easier.
Last two opponents have actually gone the distance with Thurman, even though they've hit the canvas. Thurman, of course, 21 knockouts in the 25-0 mark that he has compiled.
Joe, I'm going to let out a secret now.
What's that, Teddy?
Well, an X factor. I mean, I couldn't say anything because it would have been wrong if I said it earlier, because it could have influenced the fight and maybe helped Collazo. I wouldn't do that for either fighter.
This is a bonus fight plan nugget here.
Yeah, it really is. And look, there's an X factor, whether it's a World Series game or a Super Bowl. There's always something that is on the outside that could change the course of the game, or in this case, a world title fight. Thurman hurt his left hand in training. Very sore. There was one day where he actually had to stop the sparring and go to the doctor and check it. Now, obviously not so bad where the fight had to be canceled, anything like that. And fighters are fighters. They deal with pain. But you know that it's there. And maybe that's why the jab is not coming out as hard as sometimes Thurman jabs come out. And maybe the fight plan's right. Maybe he needs that right hand so he can save the left a little bit.
We will watch for that. That left hand to the body, but we'll just see. We'll watch the body language and the facial expression if he does land a crisp, clean left hand. Will be the first feature fight that night. That's August 1st, the next PBC on ESPN. Round two here of our main event. Thurman patiently stalking and looking to corral Luis Collazo.
Well, Collazo's shown respect, obviously, to the power of Thurman. Boxing a little bit, using those legs, using the big ring here a little bit. One problem, you can't win this way if you're Collazo. Thurman can box too.
You thought he would have to come out, Collazo, and try to make a statement early on.
Well, slow down.
Be the aggressor a bit.
Thurman a little bit. Put something negative in the mind of Thurman and put something positive in his own mind. I don't know how much positive is in the mind of Collazo at 34 years of age, to be quite frank.
Let's get some answers on Luis Collazo. In his corner is our Bernardo Osuna.
Thank you. Margarita Reina Irizarry is his mother. She's ringside, and this is the first time she's ever seen her son fight live. She saw Miguel Cotto fight in New York, but she said she's extremely nervous. And we must remember that on June 20th, she had a second stroke this year. And on the 21st, she was released. And she prayed that she would be okay so that it wouldn't affect Louis' mindset coming into this fight. And even when she was in the hospital, she told Louis to concentrate. Louis said, I was so glad that she wasn't in Puerto Rico. She was in New York when that happened with his wife, Frances, and he was able to keep tabs on her. This is what life has been like for Louis in the last couple of weeks.
So glad that Margarita, his mother, is doing much better, able to be here, make the trip down to the Tampa area to see her son.
Yeah, we're all happy to hear that Collazo's mom is recovering and she's able to be here. I think what's bothering Collazo the most right now, two fights ago he was on the floor with Khan three times and he was cut off his right eye. You know, he still has some doubts, some bats in the belfry, so to speak, some doubts in that mind that right now Thurman's not helping him with those doubts.
Left hand landed and then he split the guard with that right hand and now sends that left to the body.
Once in a while you're going to see Collazo put those earmuffs on, go into that peekaboo, just cover up right in front of you. When you do that, you give up your body. Thurman has a good left hook to the body.
Collazo now taking some half steps forward.
This is why you can't outbox Thurman. Look how quick he is.
Look at the hand speed too. You see the athleticism and the angles as we come to the end of round number two here. And Margarita looks on for her son, the former titleist, Luis Collazo. You don't know. The crowd doesn't know when a round ends. Oh, look at Riddick Bowe, Teddy, ringside for the PBC on ESPN. And Antonio Tarver, whose son fought on the undercard tonight, looked pretty good with a victory on the PBC. And one of the greats from Florida, a recent generation, Winky Wright.
Was also 154-pound
titleist.
Also trained by Dan Birmingham, who trains Thurman. Birmingham, one of the best in the business. You saw Bowe, you saw Tarver, both former world champions, both former Olympians.
Lazo sweeping with a left hand that was off the mark here to open up round three.
You know, you look at Thurman, goes to show you, can't take things for granted, can't assume something. What I mean by that, you people at home, you look at him, you see the body of an armored vehicle, you know, you see the power, you know, of H-bombs in either hand at times. But sometimes the driver has the approach of a crossing guard. In other words, it's not just about the ability. It's about what's in the mind, what's in the temperament. And the mind and temperament of Thurman is really to be careful, thoughtful, smart, but not a guy who just goes out there and looks to land hand grenades. He looks to pick spots. Again, you look at him and say, yeah, he's an armored field goal. He should run you over. But that might be the body. That might even be the engine. But the driver, the mind, is what counts. And his mind is to do this, to box and look for spots, to be careful.
But I'll tell you, when he gets into gear, it is fun to watch. Those last four rounds that many saw on national TV against Guerrero, after he scored the knockdown here, he put some punches together as Collazo tried to slip away.
I haven't seen it.
Oh, Collazo came forward, cut the gap, and now an exchange here in that neutral corner.
Yeah, he came forward, Collazo, but he got counted.
He did.
For his efforts.
Placed the left hand to the body moments ago.
Because again, Thurman can do it all. From a physical, technical standpoint, he can close the gap when he has to, and he can set traps when he wants to.
There's some swelling now under the left eye of Luis Collazo. May have come from one of those recent right hands, but that was a good counter that Thurman had. here in the third round.
Best athlete in boxing.
Keith Thurman.
I think so.
Fast, strong, powerful, accurate. Total package. So we come to the end of three on the PBC on ESPN, our main event. Round number four is coming up, and we'll see if they get after it and swing for the fences a little bit. Collazo was a bit more aggressive in that third round. Former titleist, a 15-year pro.
So Collazo has got six losses. He's never been able to win at the A or A-plus level, which is the level Thurman's at. So.
Combination from Keith Thurman right back to a southpaw right jab from Collazo.
So I guess what I'm getting at is he's never had the wherewithal to win at the level that we think Thurman's at, obviously. At some point, he's going to have to decide to go for broke.
Thurman just touching that time as he took the angle. Two-punch combination, placed two right hands to that left flank, the body of Luis Collazo. Collazo coming in behind that flicking jab.
There is one secret weapon that Collazo could possibly use. You know what that is, Joe? For a southpaw, sometimes a southpaw, what he could do is he could slip his head to his right as though he's going to throw a right hand. Drop the left hand as he does it. That could be a very effective punch for a southpaw.
See Teddy's scorecard and the fans at home. You, the viewer at home, three rounds to zip for Keith Thurman. You can score along with Teddy the ESPN Boxing Facebook page or go to ESPNvote.com/boxing. You can jump in at any point here and see if you match up with Teddy and the ringside judges at the end of the night. And Collazo pressing a bit with Thurman against the ropes, missing with that left hand. Southpaw came forward with that power punch and came up short again.
Collazo has been on the floor in five different fights in his career. Come off the floor one time to win. A funny feeling, he's gonna win. He might have to do that again before the night's over. Who would have thought when you saw this huge ring, and it's a huge ring, it looks like a lake in there, that the advantage would be to Thurman. Right, Joe? You would have thought, hey, Collazo needs a focal. He's got a trap. Thurman, his only chance is to land something. But the advantage is to Thurman. He likes the box. He likes to use the ring.
Picking a spot that time, trying to split the guard with the right hand. End of four here in Tampa. Movie The Southpaw comes out July 24th. We have a southpaw former titleist in the ring right now as Keith Thurman is teeing off on Luis Collazo. Good series of an offensive attack and included a right hand to the body. And now Collazo's covering up.
Speaking to the fight plan, that right hand landed early in this round because Collazo moved his head, you got it, to his left. 95% of the time, Thurman knows where he can find Collazo, or more importantly, finds his head on the left side, right in front of the right hand, and Thurman has landed it twice this round.
Good start to this fifth round for one-time Thurman. Todd Grisham has been monitoring the corner of Thurman. Todd.
Hey, Joe, Dan Birmingham very happy with what he's seen so far from Keith Thurman. The only complaint he has is that he wants Thurman to be the boss, put Collazo on his back foot. He wants Thurman to push the pace. He doesn't think that Collazo can do anything when he's going backwards.
First minute of this fifth round felt this way. Now Thurman circling a bit on the outside as Collazo comes forward.
I'm not so sure Collazo could do anything when he's coming forward. He walks into counters. I mean, Thurman's just a little too smart, too quick, maybe too young.
Look at the angles that Thurman can give as well. He has such a variety of offensive weapons. There he angles with a right hand and steps out the left door.
Yeah, that was a tricky punch there. He made a little slip to his left, like he's gonna go over there. Got Collazo's attention over there, and he dropped the right hand on him.
There's another well-placed right hand. Collazo missing with his right hook. He's had success with that in the past in bigger fights.
There's a lot of abilities you can have in that ring. Quick hands, quick feet, good power, good ability to adjust. One of those great talents could be great intellect. Thurman has a great intellect.
Slightly more pronounced swelling under the left eye. Not an issue right now in terms of the vision of Collazo, but it's there, something to deal with.
I'll tell you something that's an issue. There's no bell here. You know, the commission has a rule. Most commissions have a rule. Bring two mouthpieces. Why? In case you lose one. Well, maybe they should make a new rule. Bring two bells.
Collazo with his best work.
It looked like it hurt him in the body a little there.
Went to the body and had success here at the end of round five, and now he's trying to chase down the unbeaten Keith Thurman.
Looked like he hurt him a little bit to the body, and that's the right place to go. Downstairs, and he did.
Look at Collazo on the attack against Keith Thurman. Thurman's looking to wrap up.
That's where you want to go if somebody's moving. Take the air out of the tires.
Luis Collazo is a bigger underdog in this 12-round fight than Buster Douglas was against Mike Tyson. That's what the boys out in the desert have said leading up to this one. But he just took control of things there at the end of the fifth round with that big body shot. Let's see how Keith Thurman, the undefeated, tagged as the next great one, responds here.
Well, we were talking about what earlier? The versatility of Thurman, his ability to box, he's gonna need it. Stay on the outside, gonna need those legs to keep Collazo from putting any more water in his basement. And that's exactly what Collazo has in his mind. Flood that basement. Go to that body.
Earlier tonight, we saw an upset knockout win from an underdog against an undefeated. Could it happen again? Could Luis Collazo hit the jackpot here against Thurman?
Collazo should have jumped right on Thurman. At 34 years of age, it's a little hard to do sometimes.
You mentioned it's hard to hear the bell here in Tampa. The commission's using a bell that they took a chunk out of. A piece of the bell broke off. Yeah, not ringing so loudly, Teddy.
I never got finished to chance to finish saying what I was saying because obviously Collazo changed things by hurting Thurman, but no bell.
Hey, as long as we got a good fight in the ring, let's go.
The danger about no bell is when the guys are engaging, they can't hear a bell.
That's right.
Ref can't hear bell. Something crazy can happen.
Collazo reaching forward with that left hand. Thurman doesn't make him pay the price. Now on the inside, going to that belt line, and a short left hand on the inside from Collazo as Thurman comes back, sweeping with a left hand that was off the mark. Collazo takes a step forward, fires off that left. Collazo more the aggressor here. A little stop and pop from Thurman, who's glancing. Collazo able to parry that.
There's only three things Collazo has to concentrate on now. Bum in the corner, three things, not five, three. One is moving behind your jab, you know, to block Thurman's vision a little bit so he don't pot shot you when you come in. The other, cut the ring down. And the other, well, you know it already, go downstairs.
Told you about the swelling around the left eye of Collazo, but after a recent exchange, now there's just a little redness and perhaps the start of a small cut that's opening up, streaming down from the right eye of Luis Collazo as this round comes to an end, and a right hand from Keith Thurman as Collazo fights on, and the blood does stream down. On the face of Luis Collazo's mother. By the way, that cut that they were dealing with in the corner for Luis Collazo, Teles Osamenos, the referee, has ruled that that was caused by an accidental clash. Oh, sharp right hand from Keith one time.
That good body shot from Collazo a couple rounds ago not only got him on the scorecards and back in the fight, but it has him mentally back in the fight, believing he could win that. Did not look that way the first several rounds.
Our in-house Heisman Trophy winner, Desmond Howard from College Game Day, says he's impressed by the way Collazo takes a Thurman punch, keeps moving forward, keeps stalking him. Hey, you've worked with Desmond a little bit when it comes to boxing. You did a fight plan with him. He knows the game.
Yeah, he had a pretty good jab, if I remember. Better than Dicky Vitale.
Dick Vitale here ringside. A lot of athletes watching this main event across the country, including Des.
What do you hear me say all the time, Joe? 75% of this game is
mental.
What? Mental. Got to have confidence. Got to have belief. If the people in the corner, in charge of Collazo, they were doing their work, and I think they were, in that locker room, they could have told him, tonight's your night, baby. You know why? There was an upset. A big upset earlier. I know if I'm in that corner, if I'm in that locker room, I'm going to Collazo and saying, you know what? It was already one upset tonight. A guy that wasn't supposed to lose, lost. Let's get another one. Your night. And
Thurman,
you start believing that, you start acting that way.
Even with blood streaming down the right side of your face as you keep coming forward against an undefeated fighter in his hometown.
Suddenly the cut man for Luis Collazo is very important. Mike Rella. Gonna have to do his job. Collazo has been cut from head clashes. He's been involved with head clashes.
Oh, good sharp punch when he went to the side there by Thurman. As Collazo keeps hunting down his prey and Thurman looks for his spots. The crowd here chanting Keith, Keith, looking to back their local favorite.
And don't forget, Thurman's been on the floor once in his career, and he's been shaken up several times in fights. You want to know why he survives? Well, besides heart, this, the ability to get out of trouble, stay out of trouble.
They're stopping the fight based on that cut. You could hear the exchange between Dr. Carlos Rodriguez, Telles Acevedo's, and the fighter, Luis Collazo. Thurman's celebrating, but he probably shouldn't, because there was an accidental clash of heads that was ruled. They may go to the scorecards here, most likely, for a technical decision.
Luis Collazo has stepped in to wave off the contest at 1 second of the eighth round for your winner by technical knockout and still welterweight champion, Keith Watson.
What an odd way to pull it off that way, Teddy.